I know a lot of you had long nights yesterday, but I am the last speaker in the feedback session, so you can start waking up. I think it will be unfair not to start with congratulating the Geological Society of India, the Infosys, and Professor Shankar and the rest of the organizers for giving us such an amazing experience here, which was unparalleled with what I have ever experienced before. I will postpone rest of the presentaries for lunch and get to the specifics now. I have 3 minutes. I will take about half a minute for each issue that I have written over here. First thing that I would like to focus on is, although a lot of us tried to thank the volunteers here, but I think they did not still get the thanks that they deserve. Volunteers here were better than any other conference or event that I have experienced. The spirit of service in them was so good that they didn't even allow us to keep our bags, to have the discomfort of keeping our bags on our trips. So thank you so much to the volunteers. I will move on to IESO and the new things that we have tried here and how I think they have played out and how I think they can be improved. So one new thing that has been tried in IESO, probably it may have been tried before but it is not very common, is extensive private participation in the organization of IESO. We all know and we all see that it has been extremely successful, and from this we can take a cue that similar private participation can be encouraged in future IESOs. I can assure you that had there been no private participation or participation of private company like Infosys, our experience may have been lesser by an order of magnitude. Next thing that I want to move to is the experience that we have had here. So Earth Science Olympiad, I believe the main aims of the Earth Science Olympiad, I have listed down here so that I don't forget it, are giving research experience to the students, promoting international cooperation and interaction, and improving systems understanding. Now the tests that happen on the first 4 days are only the most unnecessary part of the IESO. It is great that they are finished very soon, and I believe all of us don't need to be here for the tests, because in today's world we can, if you only have to give the tests, we can give them online. So we are here for promoting these three things. Now an initiative which was taken in this IESO called the Earth Systems Project was aimed towards having all three of these things in one event. Giving research experience, I will repeat them again, giving research experience, promoting international collaboration, and improving systems understanding. Now, my 2 pence in this event is that maybe we can separate the three aims and have the systems, include the testing of the systems understanding as part of the tests, have the international collaboration as part of the field trip, and have the research exposure as part of a project from next IESOs, and we can then have that research exposure, we can ask the students, the teams, to bring a research poster from their own countries. They can prepare them, they can take much more time, and they can come up with a much better research poster instead of getting just 24 hours. The next thing that I move on to is one amazing thing, a very nice thing that was done this time by the Geological Society of India, was involvement of local schools in IESO, both students in the competitions and teachers in the activities for mentors. It was only partially successful this time. There were some concerns about the nature of IESO as being for the special students getting compromised if we involve a lot of students from local schools. To this effect, I would like to say that exclusivity doesn't lead us anywhere, friends. We need to be inclusive, we need to make as good use of IESO as possible for as many people as possible. Exclusivity argument for me, friends, is weak at best. From all the countries that are here, there will be a large portion of the population who will not, who doesn't have access to coming over here and participating in such a competition. So, as for India, 95% of people who are studying in schools right now, 95% of them will not join university or college. So, exclusivity doesn't behove us. We need to be inclusive and we need to have as much participation as possible. The last thing that I will like to go to is one another interesting thing happened was the local school visit yesterday. I would like the organizers, I would like to tell the organizers that it probably it would have been better if you would have visited a school of the government of India where 90% of Indian kids study, which has paint falling off from the ceilings, where students come only because they are given food by the government of India, free food by the government of India. That would have presented a true picture of India, and that would have given those little students to have first interaction with somebody from other countries and students from other countries, and they would have felt really happy. And it would have been so amazing to see smiles on their faces instead of visiting the private schools. So, I believe that's all I have to say. Thank you so much again for the great experience. Thank you.
I will now invite Dr. Cyril Lavoche, the chairperson of the International Geoscience Education Organization.